Welcome once again to Marriage Without Tears channel. It's my pleasure to be with you on this edition. And I know that somebody had been blessed severally in our previous editions. Today's edition is going to be awesome because the subject we are treating today is of great importance to couples out there. Whether you are a newly married couple or whether you have been married for decades, this is an awesome topic and I want you to pay ultimate attention. What is our topic today? Simple. Easy ways to achieve pregnancy. Easy ways to achieve pregnancy. I know that for most couples, pregnancy is just a very easy deal. A few sessions of sexual intercourse and the woman conceives and begins the process of incubating the baby in her womb. But to so many other couples, the story is different. I know of many who have waited for months or even years after marriage before they could even attain conception of their first child. I know of many marriages that have collapsed simply because the couple could not achieve pregnancy. But after watching this edition, surely I know you'll be blessed. And I know, of course, that the information you are going to receive will edify you. It will be an information that you will treasure for years to come. So just pay ultimate attention to this edition. My name once again is Felix Okeke. I'm your marriage counselor and coach. And if you look at this red button by my side, it's our subscription button. Please, if you are not subscribed to this channel, click on it and get subscribed. What we are doing here is simply to provide information for married couples to use and edify themselves and make their marriage a pleasure under the sun, make their marriage exemplary, make their marriage something to treasure for years to come. That is what we do on this channel. And if you are part of it, I'm sure that you are going to learn a whole lot. So, what are the easy ways to achieve pregnancy? First of all, I would like to tell you that the information I'm providing you tonight is simply a product of both training and experience. Many years ago, as a married person, many years ago, I experienced the same thing I'm about to tell you with my spouse. I and my wife, we moved from one counseling office to another, seeking counsel on how to achieve conception. For 7 years after our marriage, we had nothing. We had no baby, no pregnancy, nothing. And that meant our trip to all manner of professionals. We went from pastors to urologists to gynecologists to marriage counselors, seeking all manner of counsel. And we got so much, And I'm going to tell you some of them because in the process, we came across all manner of myths that are still being expressed several places today. And I'm sure if you're a married person, you might have heard some of them. Something like this. We went to a pastor who told us, for instance, that since we are seeking for a child, that anytime we want to conjugate, anytime we want to have sexual intercourse, that we should first of all go into 30 to 40 or 45 minutes of prayer, intensive prayer, presenting our matter to God and asking God to incubate our lovemaking by the power of His Spirit. Do a serious intensive prayer before we come to the place of lovemaking. And it sounded somehow to me, I was skeptical, because to me, does it mean that every person who have been married and achieving pregnancy, that they had to go into such intensive prayers? Does it mean that God, who united us first of all in marriage, that it does not also, does he need to be told that we need to be fruitful, we need to multiply, we need to replenish the earth? Because that is what we have been called to do. Why should we go into a separate prayer in order to achieve conception? These are myths. These are myths. That is not to say that to intercede or to pray earnestly for a child is not good. No, it is good. But at the same time, it is a cutlass which you need to sharpen ahead of time, not simply because you want to achieve conception. I call it myths. The second one we also received, an instruction we received from somebody we thought should know better. He told us anytime we want to have sexual intercourse, that my wife should put a pillow under her buttocks to lift her buttocks, and possibly after the lovemaking that she should place her feet up in the air, or even by the wall, place her feet up in the wall and allow her feet to be up there for at least 30 to 45 minutes to allow the spermatozoids to go in deep down inside. You know, before ever she leaves the bed, she should be there in that position for the next 45 minutes. And tell you what, as wonderful as it may sound, because we actually told him that any time that we finish lovemaking, that the spermatozoa, that it flows out. And that was the instruction we were given. It may sound good, but naturally I have come to realize under intensive research that it is not always the case. Because there is a difference between the sperm cells and, of course, the fluid that came, the semen. There's a difference. There's a massive difference. So it, as long as, I mean, from the right from the penis onto the vagina, the sperm flows with the semen into the uterus. And then, once that happens, the deed is done. The fluid can come out, but it does not mean that the sperm is coming out with it. That is true. So, it may not always be the case that your wife needs to put her feet up the wall or put a pillow under her. It does not make sense. It does not encourage anything. Another thing most couples want to also know is whether orgasm, I mean, the sexual intensity, what we call orgasm in a woman, whether it encourages pregnancy, whether it enables the woman to achieve conception, orgasm. And the simple answer is sometimes yes, because in the process of orgasm, there's a contraction in the vaginal walls, a kind of contracting and relaxing of the walls. As is happening during the process, you know, those spasmodic kind of movements that happens during orgasm, as is happening, it's also capable of drawing the sperm inner, deeper into the woman. So it could help. But that does not mean that if a woman does not achieve orgasm that she cannot conceive. No. You may conceive even without achieving orgasm. But orgasm can also help the sperm to be drawn deeper into the woman. Now, having said all of this, what essentially must a woman do, or what should a couple do in order to achieve conception or pregnancy easier? Number one, the woman should try as much as possible to understand her ovulation period, the period when she is most fruitful, the period when conception can be easier than other times. And what is that period? In most women, the period is in the 13th or 14th day, start counting from the first day of menstruation. If a woman has menstruated, during the monthly period called menstruation, from the first day of menstruation till the time it finishes, till the 13th or 14th day, normally half of the month, that is when most women experience ovulation. How do you also know that you have experienced ovulation? Sometimes, if you insert your finger inside of your uterus, inside of your vagina, the fluid that comes out of it is very elastic. It draws like an okra soup. It draws. And then you know that this is the most fruitful period in that woman. And as at that point also, the body is sensitive to touch. You feel like having sex all the time. That is the most fruitful part of a woman. That's the best time to have conjugation. That's the best time to have sex if you actually want to achieve pregnancy. The second thing you must do, before I tell you the second thing, I desire you to click to this red button, please, and get subscribed, because I want you to be part of this move. It's a great topic we are dealing with, especially for those who have been looking forward to having a baby for a very long time. This is a great one. And the second thing you must do as a woman, if you have been trying for months and years and you are not achieving pregnancy, I will like you to go and conduct an ultrasound, a scan. Let them check, the position of your pelvis. Let them check the position. Let them check the position. If your pelvis is tilted backwards, it makes sense that in sexual intercourse, the man should come into you from behind. It should come into you from behind. And as it comes into you from behind, it is easier for the tip of his penis to get closer and closer to the mouth of your womb. That is what it should be. And as he's doing that, sometimes he will hit the mouth of your womb and you receive a little bit of pain. Even though it's painful at that period, I'm talking about the time of ovulation. It can be painful when you are coming from, when a man is coming from behind and hitting the mouth of your womb. It can be painful, but that is the right position to be if you actually want to achieve conception, if you actually want to achieve pregnancy. But if your uterus is tilted forward, then it makes sense that the man should come unto you in what we call the missionary position, with you lying on your back and the man lying on top of you. That is the missionary position. If your uterus is tilted forward, that is the right way the man should come unto you. In that way also, the man reaches you down better than, he reaches closer. The tip of his penis reaches closer to your womb more than any other thing. So this is an ideal position. You ought to know that as a woman. In the process of lovemaking as a woman, sometimes you may also need to be on top of your man so that you will be able to control the sexual movement. You'll be able to control the mood. You'll be able to control the tempo. It's very, very also important. Very, very important. Learn to sometimes turn around and be on top. And there is also one counsel I must give you if you have been looking for a child as a couple. Don't always adopt the same position all the time. If you decide to choose the missionary style, use that missionary style for the entire month. If you discover that after that month that there is no incidence of pregnancy, then you can change it to the doggy style. Let the man start taking you from behind. It will make all the difference. So try to adopt different positions so that possibly you'll be able to get that kind of position that makes the man's phallus, the man's penis, to get closer to the mouth of your womb. That is where when he deposits semen, the semen becomes more active. It goes deep down and performs what it has been sent to do. So it's very, very important. And I want you to be very, very clear on this. And of course, the third thing you must do, check your hormonal balance. Check your hormones. Let a doctor carry out a test and be able to determine areas where you may be hormonally down. So that if there is any way you can use some certain additives, some certain things to uplift your hormones. There are so many fertility drugs out there that you can take and it can enhance your capacity to achieve conception. Very, very important. And a doctor may recommend a few to you. Get to your doctor, let him recommend a few to you. And then you can go and get quality ones from the chemist. As you begin to do that, if there's any deficiency in you, it will be normalized. And then your body will become ready to achieve conception. This video is very, very important to those who have not been having children, or to those who have had just a child and possibly they have been waiting for a second one, but it has taken years and the second one is not coming. I want you to adopt some of the measures I have mentioned in this very particular production. And I believe God that surely, surely there will be a way you will achieve conception. Finally, I want to also give you this point. It's a fourth point. I may even call it a bonus point. It's more of an emotional, spiritual thing. One of the greatest challenges to couples that are looking for a child is what I call anxiety. Anxiety has the capacity to deprive us the joy of calmness, the joy of being able to trust God, the joy of being able to even trust our spouses. Anxiety. Please, as you are believing God for a child and as you are doing so many of the things I've mentioned earlier, please be anxious for nothing. Keep your heart at ease. And I believe God that as you are doing so prayerfully, that somehow the womb will be opened and you will receive the treasure you have been believing God for. This is my challenge to you. Please, let's all put everything that is called anxiety aside and then walk proactively and believe God for your testimony. I thank you for making it time and sharing this moment with us. And I believe as you put some of the things we have mentioned earlier and even these in operation, somehow, you will receive that baby you are looking for and surely you will achieve pregnancy. And one more thing, if by any reason It has been taking a long time. Please, don't waste time in not taking tests. You and your husband, or you or your and your spouse, should go for tests continually, so that you are sure that on a physical level, that your womb is right, that your uterus is rightly positioned, that the fluid inside of you is not anti-sperm, that the sperm is in order. You need to go to test from time to time. And as you do so, surely you will receive the baby of your dreams. I thank God for making it possible for us to spend this time, and I give God praise. Please make out time, punch this red button, get subscribed before you leave this, and make out time to always abide with this wonderful channel. Thank you very much. I look forward to seeing you next week. You are blessed. You are surely blessed.